Hey guys, welcome to Deebs TCG. I'm Dylan, and today we're going to be taking a look at a new take on a deck that we've actually covered before. This is Tinkerton EX with the Gardevoir engine. So the old list that we looked at used the Altaria Squavit Bibural engine, but this new list is using the Refinement Curlia and the Shining Arcana Gardevoir for a little bit more consistency. So without further ado, be sure to get subscribed and let's go take a look at the deck. Alright, so first thing first here, let's take a look at the deck here. So, of course, Tinkerton EX is going to be our main attacker here. We're going to be wanting to use Big Hammer most of the time, as we can rack up some pretty big damage pretty quickly with this draw engine, which is, of course, Refinement Curlia, in addition to Shining Arcana Gardevoir. So, Refinement Curlia is nice because we can get it out pretty quickly, and it does allow us to just trade one card for two, which is pretty good, but obviously we want to have the Shining Arcana to just draw two with no drawback. Quite a bit better there. We do run a mana fee just in case, just for getting set up mainly, just so we don't get any Radiant Greninja dunks right away. And then we do also run a Rotom V, which is nice early in the game to get our hand well in setup there, just to get us a bunch of extra cards basically in the early turns where we're not going to be attacking anyways. In terms of items, we do run quite a bit of searching cards there to get us those, all of our like main bits there, our Ralts's and our Curlias and our Tinkatinks. We run Rare Candy. We don't run the Middle Evolution there just because it's not really needed. We can more often than not have a big enough hand to get it, just have a Rare Candy and a Tinkaton, so really no need to search either of those out. Run Switch, of course, Artisan, once again to get those out early. Path to the Peak is really nice because we don't run any Rulebox Pokemon except for Rotom V, which is only useful for us in the early game, that have abilities, so we're gonna almost want to get this out every time because it shuts down a ton of decks in this format. Arvin, just for searching out for a Forest Seal Stone as well as some sort of item. In terms of supporters, Avery is really nice because it allows us to draw three cards with no like discard or anything like that, and then get rid of our opponent's bench as well is nice. Boss, of course. Cheryl is nice because Tinkaton has a lot of HP, so getting rid of any damage counters on it can usually make it last an extra turn, which is really nice. Colriss for, again, drawing with little to no drawback. Jacques is an interesting inclusion here. Just because we do run a whole lot of evolution Pokemon, it's nice to get them out. It is also one that we can use if we want to get ourselves an extra card if we're short. Double Turbo Energy is going to be the main way that we're accelerating to these Tinkatons, and then we do also run some Reversal Energy so that we can use our Gardevoir's attack if we need to. So, let's go get some games done. Alright, let's get a game going here. Hopefully something. Okay. Gengar Box, hey? And Ghastly Coin. Maybe something Gengar? That would be weird. I haven't seen a Gengar deck in quite a while. I think VMAX's we have a pretty good advantage over, though, if that is what he's playing. And, of course, he's going to win the coin flip. Oh well. Hopefully we get something decent. Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. Come on. Come on. Yeah, I do want a couple other things. Hopefully he's planning to play here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, Lost Box, hey? Actually a tougher matchup than you would think for us. Yeah, single prizers are not great. Unless he's running the Giratina version. which there's not really any way to tell right now. So we'll probably just see two crown fees, yeah. So I figured. But really, we want to hopefully get. We'll just do that. Really, we want to get as many guys out into. If it's just Sableye that he's running for bench damage, we should be okay, because by the time he gets Sableye set up, we'll hopefully have enough for some guys. And he grabbed the fourth comfy, or is that the end of the turn? That is the end of the turn. Yeah, so I don't think he's gonna get the Sableye out for next turn. So we'll use this to get ourselves one of these guys, which is nice. That's really about it. We'll just instant charge for three. Not bad. That's pretty good, actually. I'm happy with that. Should be able to get, as long as we don't get Iono'd or something, which I don't think we will. I think he's going to want to be using his Colriss here. So, at least I would. Clara, eh? So, no jet energy for sure. He runs the water. Okay, Greninja is a real problem. Okay, so there's the Colriss. Thankfully, we're pretty good in terms of numbers with Sableye if he does manage to get that somehow. Which I don't think so. I think he's just gonna do a Cramorant here, and that'll be what happens, which is kind of fine by me. Really, I think we could use. Yeah, I think he's just gonna use the Cramorant, which is fine by me. Yeah, and Path to the Peak is fine too, because of course we do not need to worry about that, because we're not gonna use Rotom again anyways, I don't think. Assuming we can get something out, hopefully, which I would hope we are able to with all of this stuff. Okay, let's do a refinement first. Feral and Path, and we'll do that again. We'll get rid of the Path because we really don't need it. Double Turbo is helpful. It would have been nicer to get something though. The Colriss. Wow, okay, that's not helpful. Okay, we'll get a Manaphy out just in case he does have the Greninja. Okay, and I guess we'll just end our turn there. That's really unfortunate. That Jock would have been a little nicer earlier. But no Tinkatons, hey? It's unfortunate. But we'll get an attack with our Gardevoir off next turn either way, so. See what he's planning to do. He might not have a way out. He has used a lot of switching cards. Which would be good, because then we kind of shuts down his Sableye at least a little bit. Because the last thing is that going off. We probably should have gotten another Tinkatink out, just so that we're good there. But, I mean, with the Gardevoir, should help a little bit. What's he doing? Just getting onto the Sableye? Is he gonna retreat into the Sableye to take just a curly out? I mean, is that really worth it? Whatever. Thankfully we got that Manaphy out just in case. I kind of figured the Greninja would be a problem, so... let's see. Oh, he probably wants to take the Manaphy out. Oh, just four there. Okay, yeah, he wants to take the Manaphy out. That's fine by me, actually. Because we can power these guys up and make this Greninja kind of not do much. So. That's unfortunate numbers for us, but we do have a Cheryl in hand if we need it. Do that. Still Shining Arcana. We should have Refinement first. That's a mistake. Okay, we won't make that mistake a second time. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. That. Shining Arcana. Really? Didn't want to use the Jacques, if I'm being honest. Let's see. Which is he out in the Lost Zone? Pen, so he doesn't need the Confuse again. We'll just do it, whatever. It's really annoying, though. And we don't have a Super Rod, so we can't really get that back. But to be honest, we don't really need it anyways, so we're gonna do that. Which will help us a little bit. And then if he takes out a Gardevoir, it's not the biggest deal in the world. We do have some Avery's, so but I think this boss is gonna help us next turn. This is a bit of a difficult one because I don't think he's running Giratina, so he's really relying on like a Greninja to take some dunks, and probably runs Echoing Horn, which is an issue, but not too bad. Okay, we only have one energy in our Lost Zone here. Oh, interesting. He's getting rid of his own path for the to be able to use the Greninja's concealed cards. What is this? We'll put up the Rotom. Probably has a Mirage. Oh, he's gonna keep digging. I think we might be okay, because worst comes to worst, I think we just don't put anything out. Be really nice if he can't take out this Gardevoir this turn, because then we could just heal it with Cheryl. That would make me really happy, personally. I don't think he knows we run Switch. Steck's looking a little thin, so if he does take out both of our Gardevoirs, we at least have an option to just kind of chill. So I think he's looking at this Greninja, but I think we want to boss it before we do anything here. Wow, he is really digging. Really, really digging. Can't run much more energy than that. He might just dick himself out. That is fully possible. He has to take a prize a turn, so if we can heal this Gardevoir, that leaves us a little bit of room. Choose two. Attack is 50. Energy card. Well, I mean, Yeah, he's only got four. Wow, that's a bad decision on his half. Okay. Well, Cheryl, here we go. Yeah, cool. And then we'll switch into this guy here. Don't really need to Shining Arcana, so we're just gonna Big Hammer. Big Hammer moment! Might have an Iono, and that'll help him. Yeah, so kind of shuts down his Radiant Greninja at least a little bit. He has an Iono that'll help him to stop from decking out, but I don't know if he runs it. Assuming as he doesn't have any in his discard pile, I'd say probably not. It's just gonna retreat. Yeah. Really gonna flower selecting? That's a bad idea. He's gonna deck himself out. With literally one card left. Well, I think we might be okay here. Unless he does Iono, then we're a little more in a difficult spot, but I think even then we're pretty okay. We just boss something. Just see what's in there, basically. Alright, get it. Whatever you want, man. You already used a Colorist, so I don't. If it's an Iono, that's really not gonna be fun for him. He's not gonna take four prize cards this turn, there's no way. Well, let's see. Maybe he's just wasting time so that I. Yeah? Yeah. I think we sure made it quite a bit harder for him. Okay. I don't know, whatever you want, man. If he's got something cooking here. Oh, okay. He does have something cooking. That's a little difficult, that's for sure. So he's gonna take the Rotom and a bit. Well, he'll take the Rotom out, but that's all he's getting. Does he have an attach from hand? Okay. Well, let's see. He's gonna take the Rotom out, and I think this Gardevoir probably too. We can always get a reversal energy. Okay, that. Oh, he didn't even take the Rotom. Interesting. Well, I mean, we just end our turn, right? He's got nothing. Cool. Just end our turn. Nice. There we go. He got pretty close, but, I mean, yeah, that's a tough part about Lost Zone, is that when you can't deal 300 damage, you're in a tough spot. So, pretty good game there. We got it done. And although there wasn't a whole ton of Big Hammer, we did get some Big Hammer in there. So, yeah. Alright guys, thanks for watching. As always, be sure to get subscribed. It does help us out a ton. And stay tuned, we got lots more PTCGL content always, and we do have some more tabletop content coming up. We're going to do some preview showdowns right away. Pokemon Card 151 is coming out, so we'll do a couple videos on that. And then we're also going to do some on Paradox Rift, which is looking really interesting. So be sure to get subscribed and stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.